The past few years have seen a lot of papers on animals like Tanystrophius with its famously long neck and the related Proterosaurans, and this is because there was a researcher finishing his PhD on that specific group. And now that he's finished his PhD, there's another paper out by him and a few others. Looking at the entire group of Proterosoria, they essentially found that it's not a real group and we shouldn't use that name anymore. Specifically, it's polyphyletic, meaning that it essentially takes the tips of some branches without taking into account all the other ancestors that also led from that branch. Essentially, when we're doing this kind of research, we don't want to start from the tips of individual branches of different species. Instead, we want to try and start from the base end of a branch and include everything that grows from that branch whenever we form a kind of phylogenetic tree. In the phylogeny used in this study, they find Prolacerta brumi to actually fall outside of the group that includes animals like Tanystrophius. And so this essentially is what makes the group Proterosoria polyphyletic. And so it's really not that useful for understanding evolutionary relationships. The paper does, though, help to illuminate one major clade that's already been known, and that's Tanystrophidae, which essentially Tanystrophius and some of its closest relatives. They also identified a new clade and called it Dinocephalosauridae after Dinocephalosaurus, which honestly bears a lot of resemblance to Tanystrophius. And this makes sense, as these two clades are sister groups to one another. They just each took slightly different evolutionary paths in certain places. Within the paper, there's actually even more clades that are left unnamed, but that's essentially because they treat every single branch in this phylogeny as its own clade, and essentially address what the animals in there and the synapomorphies, or common traits, that each of these larger groups would then have. So there's a lot of details that goes into it, and this paper is actually fully free to access, so it will be down below in the description if you are interested in reading about some of the synapomorphies that do make these clades very distinct from one another.